There's a 9-story block of flats with his face on the side, the whole of it, from the ground to story 9. Popovich covers the whole thing. What a final. So close. Oh, speaking of so close, this will be interesting as well. Incredibly tight, this one. Names 3, 4, 5 and 6. Their lifetime bests are split by 13 one-hundredths of a second. Four swimmers, 13 one-hundredths between the four of them on paper. Well, if you clap your hands pretty much as quick as you can, something like that. I don't know if you can hear that. That'll be about 10 or 11 one-hundredths, something like that. And there's four women within 13 one-hundredths of a second. Four. Thank goodness for electronic timing. So in lane 8, Sergile of the Netherlands. In 7, it's Plankart of Slovenia. In 1, Beckman of Denmark. Within lane 2, here she is, Julie Kjeldsen of Denmark. Bronze medalist in the 50 metres freestyle. She's got great speed. What can she do here on the butterfly? And the Italians having the most sensational evening. Very nearly won that last race. It was only on the final stroke that Morisi was touched out by Grousset. Grousset, the silver medalist on the 100 metres butterfly. And now finally he's got his gold. Gold on that 100 freestyle. What a swim it was. So Di Pietro in 6 for Italy. Another Italian in 3. It's Anna Untuntunati, the European champion on the 100 metres butterfly long course. Can she win this 55 short course? Two years ago in Kazan, the bronze medal was tied for bronze. And Tuntunaki's in lane 3, and Di Pietro in 6. They tied for bronze. In lane 5 is Louise Hansen of Sweden, the Swedish women having a really fabulous meet here. They really are. Louise Hansen, the slower of the two Swedes after the semi-final, because the faster of the two is in lane 4. Sarah Jonovic of Sweden. Jonovic 5th on the 100 fly. Silver at European Junior Championships in 2016 on the 50 fly, 7 years ago. Well, the top 4, lanes 3, 4 and 5 and 6, absolutely nothing between them on lifetime best. I've got to tell you, I have no idea where the medals are going. You could say somebody could win gold, they might not even get a medal here. 3, 4, 5 and 6 at least, with Plankart 7, Chile in 8th, and let's not forget Beckman in 1 and Jensen in 2, the two Danes, they're both very quick. In Tuntunaki 3, Jinovic of Sweden 4, the teammate Hansen in 5, Di Pietro 6. So tight, 50 freestyle final European short course. Two lengths butterfly, that's it. They're out 15 underwater and they're all about 13 or 14 metres. Really good start in lane 8. That's Gio of the Netherlands. Is she going to hit the turn? Not bad at all. So, first the turn actually was Jinovic right in the centre there. Jinovic of Sweden in 4. In 5, it's Hansen. 4 and 5 at the moment. It looks like it may well be 4, is it? Who gets a touch so close? Oh my goodness, Gile gets it. Gile in lane 8. Well, she was pretty much right up there on that first 25. You don't often see, in fact it's a tie. I did say I didn't know where the medals were going. It's a tie for first. And Tuntunaki in lane 3, the third fastest qualifier into the final, the 8th fastest, tied for gold. Lanes 3 and 8. Look at that. Gile in 8 and Tuntunaki in 3. Gile from the Netherlands and Tuntunaki from Greece. Who'd have thought those two were tied for gold? Where's the bronze gone? Jinovic of Sweden. And you would not have said that Louise Hansen wouldn't have got a medal. I did actually. I think I did say you could win it and you could not get a medal. Oh my word, what a race that was. Well, she really went for it. Lane 8 down that first 25. But down closest to her, she won it tied with lane 3. So close on the finish. Wow. 6 one-hundredths of a second split. First, second and third. Tied for first. Tied for gold. And Tuntunaki and Gile tied for gold on the women's 50 metres butterfly at the European short course with Jinovic of Sweden. 6 one-hundredths of a second back in the bronze. across. So tight. Well, 13-100 split them all on lifetime best, and they didn't disappoint, did they? 18-100 in the end split the top four. It wasn't exactly the top four we were thinking of, though. Intune Tunaki, yes, but Gili on the outside, no. I think that's what the rest of the field felt. Gili on the outside in lane eight, no. Oh no, she won, lane eight.